Today I'm showing you how you get pitch, gate, and modulation information out of the grid into your VST or Bitwig instrument. If you want to save some money on Bitwig Studio and the upgrade plans, and you want to support my channel and my content, then go to my webpage, use the link to the Bitwig store, use my code and save 10% on the regular price. So let's say you are in Bitwig Studio and you have this grid here. It's only one track, as you can see, only one track with the pulley grid on it. And inside this grid, you have this gates module running and you want to have these informations, these gate informations out of the grid into your VST or Bitwig instrument. So simple as that, you go into the FX box here down below and you load my preset. You can download this preset in the description below, so easy peasy. And then you search for node grid out and load this. So now you have this preset here inside the FX box and you have now these remote controls here. And you can map now these remote controls with the inside of the grid. So we need a modulator out here, connect these two. And now we can map the gate information from the gates module to the gate knob here in front of the grid node out preset. Okay, so now we have the at least the gate informations out of the grid into the FX box here of this grid. And after the grid node out, you can now load some kind of instrument. Okay. So now you have a pulley grid inside this pulley grid, or in the FX box, you have the grid node out and the pulley synth running. Okay. That's the simple setup. You can also use now this pulley grid outside, or this pulley synth outside of the grid, but you have to use now a node receiver. And now you select the source. In this case here, it's the same track, and you select the grid node out. And from now on, this works exactly the same. The benefit is now that you can put this node receiver and the pulley synth on any track. So you don't need to have this on the same track. So you can just grab this here and move it over here and have it still running, right? On this track, you have the pulley grid with your gates information and you go out here. And with the node receiver, you grab the signal from this track, from this device, into the pulley synth, okay? So now you can see we have different remote controls here. In this case, we have pitch, and this is also a pretty no-brainer. You can go here, use a pitches module, you duplicate this modulator out, and you can hook this up. And then all you have to do is select this and modulate this remote control, right? And now we have pitch informations. Also, you can go in now here and maybe use something like a random module, and you can use this for velocity. Okay. And if you want, you can also use this for mod wheel support. So maybe you have a string library and you want to change the dynamics of the string library in contact. You can use the mod wheel and change the expression and with this control here, you can modulate the mod wheel. Also, I used here some CC knobs, CC3 to CC6. And because we are using the note receiver, the note signal also transports all the CC signals. So you can modulate different stuff on your instrument, in your contact or in your VST instrument, in your Bitwig device, and actually change some stuff here. Maybe you have, for instance, let's go here, MIDI. You need to have this MIDI modulator here. Again, for CC3, I think it was. And maybe change the cutoff here with the CC3. Okay. Go back here, and we have CC3 here. And maybe just. And now we can modulate the cutoff for the polysynth on another, on completely different track from inside the grid from this track. Okay, so let's start over and make something to play a piano with random notes, right? So we have again a polygrid, one track with the polygrid on it. Nothing is in the grid, it's completely empty. And we use maybe a probabilities device here, which is running already. And we want to change the speed of it. So maybe go for a scalar here. Disable the pre-chord and use a phase in, something like this, and use a random modulator to change the speed here. And there's a reason why I am showing exactly this example, because there's a downside to my preset, and I show you why. So now we have this running here. So this is triggering sometimes, but not all the time. All we need now is a modulator out, and of course my preset in the FX box here. So grid out. And modulating the gate. Nice. We can close this down and we go to a different track here. Use the contact. I'm loading my piano patch. Let's go. And I'm using a note receiver. Okay. And now we grab the signal from the polygrid channel, from the FX box, from the grid node out. You can already see the signal here coming. So this is the downside. As you can see here, we have the probability sliders all the way up. And now this counts in terms of the grid out preset as one note. So there's never a re-trigger happening, right? Because all the gate informations are continuously going through. So when I use an oscillator or oscilloscope here, and as you can see, we have here some zeros in it, but it's too fast basically for the grid out. So there is a workaround for this. You have to use a gate length device in front of the out. You basically can change the length of your gate trigger. If it's too long, then it overlaps and it counts as one signal. So okay, now let's use some pitch informations again. Maybe a quick pitch quantize pitches. And go to the or maybe even better, don't modulate here the rate. Instead, we are going for a bend, and we are modulating the bend. So maybe exchange this here for an gates module. Maybe use the dice and trigger the dice to get a random value, and then we use a modulator out and change the velocity. There you have it, your grid node output. Okay, there is another downside actually, I forgot to mention, but now I remember. Sometimes when you apply velocity informations here, it doesn't applies it in time for the current node. So when you send out a node, a gate signal and a pitch signal and a velocity signal, the velocity is only applied to the next node, okay? That's not so big of a problem because you can kind of, I think it's a race condition problem inside Bitwig or something like that, where the velocity is applied too late in time. So you can delay the gate signal here a little bit. So the velocity setting is applied earlier and the gate triggering is happening later here in this case, 5 milliseconds, okay? Or 0.05 milliseconds. So you give Bitwig some time to apply the velocity setting to the plate node, okay? So this is also something you have to keep in mind, but it's not so big of a problem, right? You can still apply here a small delay. But I think these are all my experiences until now. So okay, maybe let's start again to create some exponential rhythms. So we need a polygrid. Inside the polygrid, we delete everything. Then we need the gates module, of course, to create the triggering. We don't need the precode here, so we deselect it. What we need is a phase in, which is the same as before, but now we use a bend to create the exponential rhythm. Now you can see we start slow and it gets faster, right? Exactly what we need. So now inside the FX box here, we go for the grid out. I always have to select here. Node grid. Ah, it's a preset, okay. Bitwig. Okay, so now we need a modulator out and modulate the gate. So now we have a signal and we can close this down, go to a different track, use the kick drum. Before the kick drum, you use a note receiver. Where's the note receiver? There it is. We grab the informations from the grid node out and we have a have something to play with. Maybe go for 16. Okay, so now you can use the grid basically to play around with rhythms and stuff like this. Use all the tools you have available inside the grid to actually trigger notes and pitches and all the rest of the stuff. Okay, so I think it's a pretty nice preset because you don't have to think about anything, just throw this preset into the FX box. I use a modulator handle inside the grid, modulate all the remote controls, and then use a note receiver to grab the signal to a different track. Easy peasy. At last, a super pro tip. If you don't want to actually insert all the time this grid note out via this browser here, just input it once and then you go into here, remove everything, and then you go to the device, click right on it, and then save as default preset. And now every time you load up the pulley grid, you have this already inside the grid in the FX box. And you can go with the mix here to zero, so it has no effect, right? So this is the easiest and fastest way to actually get notes out of the grid every time. So that's it. Enjoy the preset. I put the link in the description so you can download it. Leave me a comment if you have some problems or when you have some feedback for me, let me know. Thanks for watching and I see you in the next video. Bye.